the fundamental data size in most computers is called a byte. I'm sure you've heard of this before. It's really just 8 bits. And this is equivalent to 2 hexadecimal digits side by side. Incidentally, the 4 bits is also in some places called a nibble. So that's a funny little unit of measurement. But really, most of the time we use bytes. So here is a picture of how a byte is laid out. So there are 2 hex digits, call them Y and Z. And then the bits inside of those are laid out this way. So these are the place values, and you can see the powers of 2 here. And so when written this way, we have the least significant bit on the right-hand side and the most significant bit on the left-hand side. So the value of this byte, 0xyz, so yz in hex, is going to be 16 times y, because that's the lowest place value here on the right-hand side of this number, and then plus z. You could think of this as z times 1, because that's the lowest place value on the right-hand side here, but because multiplying by 1 doesn't change anything, we can just think of this as z. So another interesting unit of measurement besides the byte that's often used in computer systems is something called the machine word. So a word is often the size of an address. And so in C, for instance, this would be the size of a pointer. So a lot of early computers used 16-bit addresses, so that was 2 bytes. And that would allow you to address up to 2 to the 16 bytes in memory, which gives you roughly 64 kilobytes of memory. Obviously, that's not enough memory for modern computing, and so modern computers use either 32-bit or 64-bit machine words. Most computers at this point have moved to 64-bit words, and this gives you 8 bytes for a pointer, which means that you can address a massive amount of memory, which is, if you work it out, is 16 exabytes, which is a tremendously large number of memory, or a number of bytes. Here are some prefixes that you may find useful to remember as we're working with this. So 2 to the 10th bytes is called a kilobyte, 2 to the 20th is called a megabyte, gigabyte, terabyte, petabyte, and exabyte. And so these are listed here with their rough decimal equivalent. So once we have a bunch of bytes in memory, there is the question of what order we store those bytes in. So one option is to store the higher place values at the lower addresses. So this is called Big Endian format. And so this basically just means we place the most significant byte at the beginning and then the least significant byte at the end. This is actually the way that we write hexadecimal normally. If I were, you know, writing a hex number on the board or, you know, on a slide, this is the order that I would put it in. So the most significant things at the beginning. It turns out that in actual computer storage, it's often more convenient to store this using Little Endian format. The reasons aren't terribly important right here, but it's just important to recognize that this is usually how we store numbers. And it's a little unfortunate because it's the opposite of the way that we normally think about numbers. But Little Endian is the normal default byte ordering for most modern, at least Intel-based machines. And Little Endian places the lower place values at the lower address. So for instance, here is a number. So hex 112233444, and the way to think about these is as being 4 bytes, right? We have 4 groups of 2 hex hexadecimal digits. And so if they're stored in Big Endian, we're going to have the 11 byte, and then the 22 byte, and then the 33 byte, and then the 44 byte. And as you can see, the ordering of the byte in Big Endian on disk from low address to high address is going to be the same order as in the order that we same as we generally write the number. Little Endian takes the least significant byte, so the one that contributes the least to the value. And this is not the one that has by byte the smallest or largest value, right? This is just the one that has the lowest power of 2 value associated with it. So the smallest, least significant byte goes first. So that would be the 4-4, and then the 3-3, and then the 2-2, and then the 1-1. So it's worth thinking about this a little bit. This is something that trips up a lot of people at the beginning when you're first thinking about this. We will see this in many places over the course of this semester, so you will be exposed to this at various points, but it's worth kind of pausing to think about this for a little bit. So I would encourage you to pause the video here and think through these examples, make sure that you understand them. Feel free to ask questions on Piazza or where else, wherever else in office hours if you don't understand these conversions. But this is something that you'll need to eventually become comfortable with in working in this course. So here's a question that you can think about after you've examined the previous examples, just to make sure that you understand what's going on here. So what is the byte in the highest address when this number is stored in Little Endian ordering? So if we think about this for a second, if we store this in Little Endian, so this is two bytes, right? So it's 8-3 and 4-5. In Little Endian, the least significant byte goes first, so that will be at the low memory address, the lowest memory address. So that's the 4-5 byte. That's going to be at the lowest address, which means that the byte at the highest address is going to be the 8-3. So the answer here is A.